Easter greetings to you and welcome to worship with St. George's. We are delighted that you are worshiping with us and sharing in this celebration of our Lord's resurrection. We invite you to participate fully in our worship service. If you have received an email with the order of service attached, please go ahead and pull that order of service out, and that will walk you through the entire service. If you are joining us by virtual means and you would like to participate in this service, you can join us by utilizing our Book of Common Prayer. You can, if you have one at home, that's great, but you can also access it by BCP online. So please go ahead, join us in worship today as we celebrate this magnificent, wonderful, wonderful day of our Lord's resurrection. The opening sentences begin on page 77 of the Book of Common Prayer.
Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. On this day, the Lord has acted. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Continuing on page 80. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Continuing with Christ our Passover on page 83. Let us speak Christ our Passover together. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast, not with old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death that he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Alleluia. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia. Continuing on page 84 with the appointed psalm, Psalm 118, verses 1 through 2. And 14 through 24. This psalm can be found in your Book of Common Prayer on page 760. Reading verses 1 through 2 and 14 through 24 of Psalm 118 together. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let Israel now proclaim, his mercy endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. There is a sound of exultation and victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord has punished me sorely, but he did not hand me over to death. Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter them. I will offer thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. He who is righteous may enter. I will give thanks to you, for you answered me and have become my salvation. The same stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. On this day the Lord has acted. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The first lesson, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter began to speak to Cornelius and the other Gentiles. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us, who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Continuing in your prayer books on page 85, Canticle 8, page 85 of your prayer books, let us recite Canticle 8 together. I will sing to the Lord, for he is lofty and uplifted. The horse and its rider has he hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my refuge. The Lord has become my Savior. This is my God, and I will praise him. The God of my people, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a mighty warrior. Yahweh is his name. The chariots of Pharaoh and his army has he hurled into the sea. The finest of those who bear armor have been drowned in the Red Sea. The fathomless deep has overwhelmed them. They sank into the depths like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, is glorious in might. Your right hand, O Lord, has overthrown the enemy. Who can be compared with you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, awesome in renown, and worker of wonders? You stretched forth your right hand. The earth swallowed them up. With your constant love, you led the people you redeemed. With your might, you brought them in safety to your holy dwelling. You will bring them in and plant them on the mount of your possession, the resting place you have made for yourself, O Lord, the sanctuary, O Lord, that your hand has established. The Lord shall reign forever and forever. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The second lesson, a reading from the letter to the Colossians. If you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Continuing on page 94 of your prayer book, let us recite together Canticle 19. O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Gospel according to John. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciple set out and went toward the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came following him and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed. For as yet they did not understand the scripture that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you looking for?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabuni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brothers and say to them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'" Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told him that he had said these things to her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. God, open our ears to hear your word. Open our hearts to receive your word. Open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world around us. And open our lives to the infinite possibilities born of your love. Amen. For many of us who are gathered virtually this day, it will mark the first Easter day on which we have not been gathered in person with church family and with our own family and friends from near and far to celebrate Christ's resurrection. But it's also probably the first time that most of us have lived through a global pandemic of this kind. To be certain, for some of us, these weeks during which we have been sheltering in place to slow the spread of COVID-19 have been days of grieving. Grieving the loss of those who are dear to us, who have fallen to this disease, or days during which we have struggled with not being able to be at the hospital bedside of a loved one. For some of us, healthcare professionals and essential workers, this has been a time of fear, a frightening time of being on the front lines, praying to remain healthy, praying that we not expose our family members to this stealthily approaching sickness for which there is not yet a proven treatment. For some of us, this has been an anxiety and uncertain time as jobs and income have vanished overnight and our sense of security has evaporated. For some of us, this time has been especially lonely as we hunker down at home to avoid sickness. We are missing loved ones and friends from whom we are physically apart. For some of us, it may just have been a busy, hectic time. We've been trying to juggle far more roles and responsibilities than we've ever, ever tried to juggle in a single day. For some of us, it's been a blessed time of renewal, days during which we have been able to commit ourselves to reading and relaxation and reflection, deep conversations for which we never seem to have time, and mending broken relationships. The year 2020 will be a year to remember for the myriad of all of these emotions that have filled us, either with fear or dread or a sense of loss, or with hope and expectation and possibility. And as difficult as it is to say, perhaps Christianity needed just such a time as this, so that God's people might ground ourselves in the holiness of this time, to be reminded of the love of our God for each and every one of us, and to take stock of what is truly of value in our lives, our relationship with our God, our relationship with our neighbor, our health, looking after those around us who need our support, offering a kind word to the person that we greet, because now, maybe for the first time, we really have a sense that we don't know the tumultuous times that everyone might be going through. There is no way to greet this holy day that is also a day in which so many are in pain and suffering around us without asking ourselves a critical question. Where is the resurrection light this day? I'd suggest that there are some places where we truly, truly see it. I believe we see resurrection light in relationships that have been repaired, in new relationships that have been formed, some out of pure necessity, as we've had to come together in unprecedented ways during this time. I believe that we see resurrection light in terms of neighbors helping neighbors, whether it's through performing drive-through COVID-19 testing or supplying food to the hungry, supplying shelter to the shelterless, or just checking in with a phone call to say, how are you? I believe that we see resurrection light in those who are growing to set aside their differences, those human-made boundaries, in order that they can work together well to support the vulnerable. I believe that we see resurrection light as our own eyes are being opened to poverty and economic insecurity and inequality around us. We see what has been laid bare before us now as a result of this disease. Our poorest urban neighborhoods are being ravaged by COVID-19. Disproportionately, our poor and persons of color are dying. People who had been able to hang on by just a thin thread have now fallen off the economic cliff. Our food pantries are stripped bare as the unemployed hungry try to make it through another week. School children in our most vulnerable areas who already attend the lowest performing schools are unable to keep up with online assignments where there is no internet or computer at home. And now they have lost months of learning. We may have tried to ignore poverty before. We may have tried to ignore inequality before. But now we see clearly in resurrection light what this disease has laid bare before us. And we see our call to action. But perhaps most significantly, Christians find resurrection light in recognizing that as much as we love our spaces, as precious as these church buildings are to us, these edifices are not the church. The church is the worshiping body, and from all of the places scattered that we may be, from all of the places that we may gather, we are still united one to another and to our God. The building isn't what makes us church. The people are what makes us church. On the day that the resurrection was first celebrated, there was no spectacular worship space. The resurrection was literally celebrated in the place of the dead, a tomb. There were no joyous hymns or organs or brass, only the sound of Mary Magdalene weeping. No crowd was gathered. She was alone in the darkness before the morning light, broken, grieving, hurting, lost. After everyone else had gone home. And then Jesus made himself known to her, called her by name. Right there in the darkness, in the brokenness, in the grieving, in the pain, in the solitude, in the place that reeked of death. Jesus let her know that she was not alone. And he sent her forth to share with the world the good news that Jesus is alive. Today, even as a global pandemic would want to threaten to hold us in its grip, it cannot overcome us. For we are not alone. Jesus is with us too, in our darkness, in our brokenness, in our grief, in our pain, in the place that reeks of death. And the one who knows us, the one who loves us, calls us by name. As he invites us to walk with him in the resurrection light. And for just such a time as this, a time in which there is so much fear and uncertainty, we the church, we are sent forth to share the good news. We are sent forth to see the face of God in one another. We are sent forth to purposefully seek reconciliation and justice and healing for all of God's people. We are not alone. God is with us. The God of our ancestors, the great I am, the God who was and is to come, will never leave us. Thanks be to God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Continuing together on page 96 of your prayer book, in light of the resurrection and in the resurrection light, let us affirm our faith together with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth,
your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten,
nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God,
and sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
O God, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to the death of the cross, and by his glorious resurrection delivered us from the power of our enemy. Grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen. Continuing in your order of service, or on page 387 of the Book of Common Prayer, let us pray for our own needs and those of others. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church, that we all may be one. Grant that every member of the Church may truly and humbly serve you, that your name may be glorified by all people. We pray for Michael, our presiding bishop, Phoebe, our bishop, Dorothy and Noah, our priests, and all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments. We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world, that there may be justice and peace on the earth. Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake, that our works may find favor in your sight. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble, that they may be delivered from their distress. Remembering especially our brother in Christ, Bob Laurie, give to the departed eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy. May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom. God, we remember before you this day all those on our parish prayer list: Sylvia, Stuart, Ronald, Elizabeth, Susan and Kimbrough, Kay, Jim and Emmy, Mary, Renee, Allison, Katie, Loreen, Marianne and Bill, Laura, Mary and Ralph, Bill, Rachel, Claire, Proby, Jeremiah, Robin, Philip, Jay, Patty, Don, Judith, Brian, Joan, Ann, Karen, Jim, David, Russell, Ann, Billy, Margaret, Rebecca, Beth, Aaron, Adrian, Bill, Joy, Ashley, Peggy, Rebecca, Michaela, Herbie and Patty, Marjorie, Danny, Jackie, Oren, Mary, Doris, Alicia and Baby, Sarah, Stephanie, Bailey, Zan, Ann, John, Jennifer, Foxy, Jackson and family, Connie, Imogene, Betty, Michael, Peggy, Jim, Joan, Brian,
Cindy, Sean and family, Katrina, Brian, Wendy, Doris and family, Rebecca, Isabel, Albert, Thaddeus, John, Brett, John and Vicky, Jean, John, Eric, Whitney, James, Lola, Ronnie, Juan, Bob, Sarah, Bud, the Laurie family, Gary, John. We remember especially all those who have been affected in so many ways by the novel coronavirus throughout the world, the sick, medical professionals who are tirelessly caring for the sick, the quarantined and fearful, the lonely and anxious, those whose businesses and employment are at risk, musicians, actors, and other artists whose performing opportunities have been canceled, students whose studies have been disrupted, those who are struggling with significantly reduced income and who fear displacement from their homes, those who are hungry and do not have sufficient food to eat. We pray also for the leaders of government throughout the world, that they are led to wise actions and right actions and decisions for the welfare of all of God's people and peace throughout the world.
Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you. For the honor of your name. Amen.
Amen.
Continuing now with the general thanksgiving, which is found on page 101, 101 in your prayer book. Reciting together. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ,
for the means of grace and for the hope of glory.
And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.